everybody. This is going to be a great investment of your time today. I am going to deposit into you a wealth of information that is guaranteed. I said guaranteed, just like Geren, the guarantee Gatling. I can guarantee it's going to make you a better marketer and or salesperson. And it doesn't matter what company you work with, what your position is in the company. In fact, because of my experience over the years, this will help anybody. I don't care if you're the CEO, I don't care if you're the senior guy, the regional person, male or female, makes no difference. Or if you're the new person, that's what I really want to focus in on, are new people that are in the vacation club / timeshare industry, hotel, restaurant management, that type of thing in business, guaranteed to help you. No question about it. And guys, the great news is it's free. This is free information. It's just in my heart. And I want to share it with you because I have seen hundreds of people over the last 12 years, trained them, seen people come in with great potential and fail when there's no reason why they should. In fact, your company did not even hire you thinking that you could not do the job. That's why they hired you. They know you can do it. You have the potential. So why are so many people failing? And why do we have such a revolving door in our business? I think a lot of it has to do with training or lack thereof, or people not knowing the main things I'm going to show you today. I want you to pay particular attention to the second half of what I want to talk about. I'm going to start out by talking about how I got into this industry, where I am now, my accomplishments, and why I am qualified to talk to you today. This is going to be a great investment of your time. I would also like you to listen to this again. You might want to listen to it once a week. If you're new in the vacation club industry, listen to it 5 times a week. Listen to it before you go to work. On your way to work, just be listening, get motivated, get amped up, get ready to pop and go into work and be productive. Be a producer, not a drama queen, a producer. Well, you get to the job and your job loves to see you coming. They know, woo, we got some work gonna happen here today. That's what we want. All right, so let me begin. I just wanted 2 minutes to tell you how I got into this. It was years ago, I was sitting in a meeting. Quite frankly, it was an AA meeting, and I was there not because I wanted to stop drinking, because I wanted some hot coffee and a warm place to be, because I didn't have nothing. I was homeless. And someone said to me, Gary, why don't you go work for so-and-so? And I want to be careful not to mention people's names here. And I thought, they said, you go make some money. And I needed money. And I was like, yeah, I'm going to go work for her. And she took me down to a place called National Harbor in Maryland. And I did this thing called lead generation. Y'all know what that is, where you have people fill out the slip that qualifies them to do presentations. I didn't know what that was. I just knew I had to get people to fill the slip out and drop it inside a little bucket. And while I was doing that, this lady was watching me. And I'm thinking, what's this lady keep watching me for? I mean, she stared at me for like 10 minutes, maybe longer, just kept watching me. And all of a sudden, she walked up to me and said, listen to me carefully. You need to come work with us. Watch this, y'all. People will recognize your potential. And when people recognize it, latch on to that. See, that person came into your life for a reason. You are not two ships just passing in the night. Everything happens for a reason. And she said, you'll make about $100,000 a year. And I'm looking at this lady, and in my mind, I'm thinking, this lady lying. She's crazy. $100,000. Baby, I don't even have $10 in my pocket. I'm thinking, what is she talking about? And then I started thinking, while she's talking, I said, you know, if she's half right, that's $50,000. I said, man, even if she's 25% right, that's how my mind thinks. I said, that's $25,000, and I have nothing. I told her, I said, you know what? I'm off on these 2 days of the week. I'll come and try it out. If I like it, I'll stay. Did you know I started that same weekend on a Saturday, work Sunday, and I never went back to the old job? I said, my God, that's all I have to do is get people to fill out some slips and send them on a tour, a presentation. I said, I can do that. This is the easiest money I've ever seen in my life. Long story short, I went on to have her job. I became the senior marketer. All of a sudden, I was the guy, like the director of this vending company. And I won't say the name of the company. for infringement purposes. But man, I went right to the top. The owner didn't even have to be there anymore. I ran the whole thing, and I came from nothing, knew nothing about timeshare, knew nothing about sales presentation, knew nothing about vacation clubs, but went straight to the top. I've trained people how to book a tour in malls. I can train people to book tours at events. I can book people to do shows. I don't care what type of vending event it is. And now I do in-house marketing for an outstanding vacation club, and I'm rising there. My first year there, and I have to give you this so you can see I'm qualified to show you what I'm going to teach you today. First year there, went straight to the club. They call it Club Elite. I went straight to the first year. And amongst stiff competition, in fact, all the people I worked with are now managers and supervisors. I was among some stiff competition the first year, still made Club Elite. And so I'm a blessed man. Used to be homeless. Now we live in a house. It's paid for. We don't sweat on bills anymore. Everything's paid. No pressure. No problem, baby. And I'll show you how I went from the bottom to the top. And the things that I'm going to show you today, especially you young learners and listeners, is how to get your potential to come to the table. How to get the cream that's already in you to rise to the top, because you got it. You can do it. All you really need is some training and somebody to show you how to bring out that potential, and you'll go straight to the top. Are you ready to learn something? Would you please make sure you have a pen, a highlighter, get you a notepad? I'm going to show you some powerful things today. And would you please put this stuff into practice? That's how you're going to make it, sweetheart. I found out that the good things that we want in life, they just don't fall on you like ripe cherries off of a tree. I found out you literally have to stretch out and pick the cherry, make something happen. Okay? All right. So the first thing I want to do is give you the title of all this. I call it A Day in the Life of a Champion. The day in the life of a champion. That's me. I'm a champion, and I'm going to show you how to be a champion. It won't be long. You're going to go right to the top in your company if you just practice these simple principles. And remember, I'm a seasoned vet, and that's not bragging. It's just facts. Been through the fire, come through the fire, started at the bottom. Now I'm here. All right. A day in the life of a champion. Colin Powell was quoted as saying, "Great leaders are great simplifiers." So I made this thing so simple, anybody can do this. And I'm making sure that every one of these points start with P. So get your pen, write these things down, and then practice them. There goes a P right there. Practice these things. Number one, purpose. You know why a lot of your people in the company are failing? They don't know their purpose. That they just don't know. If they did, it would get them committed and drive them to get through the hard places in their life and be producers at your company. They have to know their purpose. When you even hire people, make sure they know where they're going. What do they want in life? Do they even know why they're here on the earth? Most people don't. No vision, no dream. And when you don't have those things, I mean, you're just like a leaf in the wind. You're being blown around by life. You're like a boat in the water with no sail. I mean, you're just being drifted wherever you want to go. You're like an arrow that's been shot out with no target. Don't know where you're going. You have to have vision. Have to have dreams. Have to have goals. You have to have a purpose. How is this going to affect my family? How is this going to affect my education, my future? My family, I have children, you have a wife or a husband, you have your spouse. You know, does this job provide a way for me to reach those goals? How much money do I really need? When I used to hire people back my old other company, I would ask them questions like this. I didn't even want, they would try to give me their resume. You know what I did with it? Right in front of them. I just put it down, throw it down. I don't want your resume. I already read your resume before you got here. I want to know about you. What are your goals? How much money did you need to make a month? It shocks them all the time. You'd be surprised how many people don't even know how much money they need a month. You need to know this stuff. How much money do you need? Okay, and live comfortably, I would tell them. I'm talking about after you paid your bills and you did what you needed to do and you still have a little money left over. What's that number? See, you got to get people to know these things. How much money do you need? See, and then show them. Get a board. I used to write it out for. Let me show you how you can get. You say you need $2,000. That's $500 a week, right? Let me show you how you can get that. See, you have to help people dream. You have to paint the picture. You have to create desires in people. Get them to see it. See, because most people are not thinking on it on their own. And if you can get them to see that and then latch on to it, have some principles about yourself, purpose and principle. What drives you? What's the inner drive? For me, it's love. I just love people. I love doing good to people. I love forgiving people. Those are like my main principles in life. Everybody has to have that red line. Things they're not going to do. See, because they're thinking, no, my family, what about my wife? How is this going to affect? See, when I'm coming to work thinking like that, I'm telling you, you got a producer on your hands. All righty. Number two, preparation. After your people have recognized their purpose in life, what they want, how far do they want to go in the company? Because most companies, especially those really good timeshare companies, they have plans in place. There's room for growth and improvement. Is that one of your dreams? How are we going to accomplish that? See, it takes preparation. You got to prepare yourself. That's my second P. And it normally starts from the inside out. Let me give you the day in the life of a champion, how I do it. From the moment I open my eyes, I'm focused. Purpose. I know where I'm going. I start my preparation and it starts from the inside out. After I freshen myself up, I go right to my study. That's where I put in most of my reading time. First thing in the morning, I'm reading. That's my meditation time. Thinking about where I'm going, what I want to do, what I want to accomplish. Did you know that most people only read one book a year? Just one. Well, if they practice what I'm showing them, they'll read more than one book. Just start reading and thinking. You should have your goals on a board where you're looking at it. See, family could be sleep. Think about that family, that spouse that's sleeping. Those children are getting ready to wake up and go to school. How am I going to provide for them? See, I'm thinking about this kind of stuff. See, so you prepare yourself from the inside out while you're sipping your coffee or something. I'm sitting there thinking, I might spend anywhere from an hour, sometimes 2 or 3 hours in that room. My wife would be like, will you come on? You got to go to work. Well, sometimes I'm just so focused. I love it. Love thinking. So prepare yourself and then start with physical exercise. I'll go to the gym. Go for a walk. Go lift some weights. Most people are underperforming at work because they don't feel good about themselves. Bad health. Depression, all kind of stuff going on in their lives. But you know, if they woke up and take the time to prepare yourself, look at your purpose, your principles, your goals, think about what really matters in life, your family, and you prepare yourself and you take that time to sit down, sip your coffee, have your breakfast, read your book, and think a little bit. Get involved in people like the Maxwells of life, the Grant Cardones of life. There's some really good thinkers out there, the Warren Buffett. Go listen to those people on videos and you get some thinking, get something turning in your head. See, they drive you. Go listen to successful people. Prepare yourself. It has to do with training. And then work your physical body. Get that thing an optimum health and strength. I mean, you come into work with pop and zest because you feel good. You spend some time thinking. You exercise. And by the way, get yourself some proper fuel. Brother Geren, why are you talking about this stuff? I thought you were talking about marketing. I'm showing you why people with potential as marketers are failing. If they knew their purpose, if they knew principles, if they would prepare themselves, train. See, get the proper rest and the proper fuel in your body. Baby, you'll be productive. Don't worry about that because you already have the potential. That's why they hired you. Okay, they saw it in you. That director, that hiring person, he or she, they're experienced. They can look at you and tell she got it. He can do that. That's why they hired you, sweetheart. Okay, we just need to bring it out of you. By showing you, I need to know my purpose, I need to have some principles about myself, and I need to prepare myself because life is just not going to drop all these good things on me. I got to go pick some cherries, pick some apple, peel the banana and eat it. You just don't eat a banana whole. Work on that thing. Got it? All right. Number three, personal problems. I've seen some talented people fail at marketing because they don't know how to handle personal problems. Let me share something with you. Everybody has them. Everybody has them. What I've learned to do is when I pull up at the job and park my car, I park my problems. I'm going to say that again because this is so important. I said, I have learned to do. When I park my car, I park my problems. I don't bring them into the job. There's no one at my job that knows anything bad about Geren Gatling. In other words, personal problem. Always having problems at home. Always got this bill. Oh, I parked them. It would be very immature of me as a champion, as a producer, to come into the job and dump all my mess on you. See? I'm hurting you, especially if you're a newbie. Now here I am, the champion, the senior guy. You're dumping my problems on you. You already have problems, honey. You don't need mine. Park them. You can never be productive when you carry personal problems into the job. Never. It's all over your face. I watch people that you can tell they're going through problems. The way they sit there and their body language, you can tell they are hurting, baby. See, they didn't learn how to park their problem. You got to park them at the door. See, when you come to the door, leave all that stuff there. You can always address it, and you should. If you have a really good company like the one I work for, they even have stuff in place for that. There's people you can call. Send an email to. They'll get somebody to help you. And most companies will even with insurance to pay for some of that stuff. See? And that's another reason why it's good to have a spiritual mentor, somebody you can look up to, talk to. Okay? Because everybody has stuff like that. Everybody has problems. And we have to address them. But we do not have the right as champions to dump those problems on other people at the job. You got to park your problems. Are you listening to me? All right. Number four. Ready? Positivity and pop. Positivity and pop. Man, when I get out the car, I come in, I am fired up. I mean, I'm ready to go. Ask people at the job. I come in, tell them I'm coming in hot. Oh, I just feel good. You know what? I'm rested. I got proper fuel in my system. I've already exercised. I've already did my little meditation. I'm focused. I know what I want, especially on a Friday. Friday's the biggest day in my company. I like to get my little phone and I'm sitting in the car and it's just sitting up there and I'm watching a hunting video. Big cats. I like to watch cheetahs and lions, you know, and I like to watch them attack gazelles and how they hunt. And I like how the narrator says she has to get some food today. Her cubs are hungry. She hasn't eaten in days. I love hearing that. And then I watch them. See, I watch how they hunt and they're serious, bro. They focus. They're not thinking about personal problems. No, they're not going around crying and whining. Nobody gonna feed me and play victim. I'll watch those big cats. They go get that gazelle. They go get that goat. They hunt zebras. They go. I saw a lion yesterday. Yesterday was Friday for me. Jumped on a rhinoceros. A hippopotamus. A big old hippopotamus. Like she jumped on him and she just trying to get to that skin. She hungry. You see, listening to me? So that's part of that preparation, man. And when I come through that door at work, I am like, whoo, I'm ready to jump on something. Book me some tours. I'm excited. Okay, you got it? This is so, so, so important. So you come in with positivity and pop. It's game day. When I walk through the door, I see myself as like Tom Brady. I'm the GOAT. I'm the greatest of all time. Yeah, I'm basically a legend in my own mind. You know, I'm Mr. Elite. I'm the senior guy. I'm going to win today. I got family at home that need to eat. I got bills to pay. I got dreams. I got visions. I got a purpose. I'm coming to get me something to eat. See, that's how I'm thinking. And when I come in, I'm focused. And then always part of the preparation, make sure you have your tools. Are you marketers listening to me? Don't just come in and sit and mope and groan and where's this way. Get involved, baby. Go get your invitations ready. Make sure you got your clovers or your vice you're going to take your deposits with. Make sure you got your staplers, your tape, your pen, your name tag is on. I don't go to work without my name tag. You don't have to ask me what my name tag is. I'm ready to hunt, baby. If they give you an iPad or some type of device to work with at work, make sure it's charged. Everything. You just want to be like, you're a soldier. See, you're there on purpose. And especially if you have dreams or part of your goal is to rise up the chain of command, and at some point be in charge and make, watch this, more money to pay more bills and get out of debt and education for your children. If you're thinking like that, you want them to see that she's my girl. That girl is always on time. When she's running late, she'll let you know. You know she's coming. When she's coming, she's positive. She's producing. She knows her purpose. See, that's what you want people to see in you. So be ready, prepared, full of pop, positivity, energy. See, do something to make yourself excited. Watch those videos. Listen to those guys that already been there and done that, that talk about money and know how to be successful, that came from the bottom and now they're here. Listen to those people. It excites you when you walk through the door, you're ready to go, and you can operate at what I like to call optimum results. To produce at a high level consistently, you have to practice these things. See, because life happens. There's deaths in the family. There's this that happens. Children, stuff happens. See, but you still got to have your purpose. You still got to be laser focused. You still have to prepare yourself. You still have to learn how to park your personal problems, train yourself, and come to your job with positivity and pop. Because remember, you have a purpose. You have a goal. You're going somewhere. And problems shouldn't stop you from getting to your purpose. Because problems happen to everybody. Are you listening to me? All right, let's go to work. Now we're ready to book a tour. See, now you're ready. If you haven't done these things, you're not ready. That's why people have problems. I very rarely have bad days. I just really don't have them. You know, always booking. A bad day to me is I got like 6 out of 10 people. As you see, I see 10 people, I got 6 of them. Or maybe 5. That's you know, to a new person, that might be great. But for me, I need 70% or more. I need to book everybody. 70, 80%, 100%. I need to book high. See, that's a great day for me. All right. So the first thing we do, when you know that you're the next man or woman up, and here comes that guest into the lobby, or that guest by the boardwalk or the mall or wherever you're doing booking tours, the first thing you want to do, ready, is profile and predict. Listen to me, from what the day in the life of a champion. And I do this with every guest. I profile and I make a prediction. When they say, Geren, you're up, and I say, that's my person, I immediately profile. I watch them. I look at how they dress. I watch the body language. I watch how the man's demeanor is towards his wife. I try to see who's in charge. Who's the decision maker out of those two? I'm watching. Or I want to know, why is she the one checking in, but he's sitting in the car? And I watch him and how he handles himself with the bus, the bellman. I watch all of that. I'm profiling. I'm predicting. Oh, this guy's like that. Oh, she's the decision maker. I need to really talk to her because she's going to be the one that's going to call. See, I'm predicting. I'm profiling. Can you see that? You should do that with all of your guests. Watch them. Watch their body language. We call it lobby awareness. Know what's going on in the lobby. Know what's going on around you. The energy your guest is putting out. You need to see that kind of stuff. It will help you in the booking process. Are y'all listening? All right. So profile and predict. Here's another word. Discovery. Notice that all of these start with P. Profile, predict, and pre-discovery. So in other words, I go to my, in our company, we use an iPad. And there's certain things I already see about the guests. Have they toured before? What state they came from? It might let me know their status, whether they're VIPs, priority owner. You can see all that stuff on the screen. See? So I see that. I do a pre-discovery. I want to know where you're from. And then I'm already relating. I'm predicting and profiling. Okay, she's from New York. I'm from New York, so I know we're going to talk about New York. Or they're from California. Great, they're from the big city. And I know a mindset about different regions. I know how northerners are, southern people, western part of the country. People, they have a certain way of thinking. So I already know how to approach them. See, I'm doing a pre-discovery. See, I want to know some things about you. Sometimes in my prediction, I can watch people by the haircut. He's military. He's a government worker. Or I watch the wife, and a lot of times I can tell she's a nurse or a teacher. And a lot of times you're right. See, that's why you do it. So it helps your pitch to be more comfortable. You already have stuff you can relate to. Because 9 times out of 10, that person that's getting ready to walk over to your desk, they've been through this before. They've been through this dozens of times. Some people for years know that you're getting ready to approach them. And you have to be different than everybody else. There has to be something about you that's totally different. Because here's a tip, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. If those people don't like you, they're not going anyway. Okay? You want to make sure you always, here's another word with a P, present yourself as the professional. Present yourself as the professional. When I approach people, when I go to work, I'm usually like this, or even if I do wear a polo shirt, it's clean, it's pressed. See, I make sure that I'm shaved. I want you to see a mustache is trimmed, my hair's done, you know, putting off a good scent, not overpowering, but just enough to let you know, this guy's got a refreshing crispness about him. Or ladies, they should see that in you. See, they should see, this is a professional lady talking to me. This is not the lady down at 7-Eleven with a cup in her hand asking me for a quarter. This lady's a professional. That's what you want. Because the people more than likely that are vacationing at your club, these are professional people, folks, that take vacations with their families. Teachers, doctors, lawyers, businessmen, businesswomen. They can't be approached any old kind of way. They're professional people just like you. They know how to profile and predict. They know how to read body language. They know about aura. They can sense when you have it and when you don't have it. When you actually care about them or when you don't. They know when you're genuine and when you're not. That's why our purpose, our preparation, our positivity, our pop, all those things mean something. Because when you come through the door, you bring an aura with you. See? And you're going to affect people, and you're going to affect the atmosphere in the lobby or your job or wherever you are. And can you imagine if you have a whole team operating like this, where the whole team comes in, they know their purpose, why they're here, they have goals, they eventually want to be a manager, they eventually want to lead something, they want to save enough money to do this, they have plans. Everybody comes in like that, where everybody's prepared. Everybody made sure they had themselves a good meal, they rested, see? And they come through the door with energy. Can you imagine how productive your team would be? But folks, we have to teach our people this. They can already book a tour. You know they can. You would have never hired them. See? But we have to constantly remind them, keep your eyes on your purpose. Keep your eyes in focus. Don't forget your children. You said your goal was such and such. Okay, so to get that done, that behavior is not going to work here. Come on, sometimes you got to shake your person. Okay, get them refocused. That's part of a job as a leader and a manager. Anyway, next word. Ready? I already gave you profile and predict and pre-discovery. Ready? Here it goes. Prophesy and be proactive. I'll say that again because you should be taking notes. We're learning something today. I'm investing in you. I'm depositing wealth of information in you. You put these things to practice, you'll be productive. You'll be the producer. You'll produce optimum results. You'll separate yourself from the rest of the pack. You'll be the lead wolf pulling the sleigh. See, you don't want to be the wolf in the back. You want to be the wolf in the front. You want to be Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. You want to lead. You guide the team today. Ah, doesn't that sound good? Yeah, you want to be that person. But you have to have purpose, baby, and prepare yourself and have some pop and positivity about you so that you separate yourself from the rest. And those leaders will start seeing that potential in you. And then the numbers will back it up. See, that girl can produce. That guy can produce. And they see it in you. Isn't that wonderful? All right. So prophesy and predict. So once they tell me that that's my person, I've already profiled. I made a little prediction in my head of how I think this is going to go because I'm prepared. It's like a boxer. You know, I'm getting ready. I know. See, this guy's got long arms. So I know I need to get. See, I'm training. Tom Brady does that. The great Mannings of the world, the great Michael Jordans of the world. These guys train. See, they know their opponent. The Floyd Mayweathers of the world, before they get into the ring, they've studied. The Serena Williams. See, these people train, y'all. That's why they're champions. You want to be a champion? You want optimum results? You want to book some tours and be the club elite or whatever your company calls you guys and ladies? You want to be that person? You want your children to be able to have the things that she has and make it through school and has the clothing and has money deposited for her future in education. You're going to need some money to do that stuff. See, so we prepare ourselves. We get out there and get it done. And let me interject this before I go on. Most of those great vacation club companies, they have all this stuff in place for you, all kind of programs. Baby, read those emails. When your company's putting out little videos, our company, they put out videos and everything. I watch them. I want to know what the CEO is thinking. See, I want to hear what you have to say. See, I want to see any things about health, and you can invest in this and 401k. I look at that stuff. I read them, y'all. I want to know how you think. You're leading me. You're the head of the company. I need to know what you're thinking, because I have purpose. Can you help me get there? See, then I have to give you all I have. I have to bring my potential to the table every day that I go through the door. OK, so most of those companies have those things in there for you, and there's room for growth, and you can be successful. See, but you have to stay laser focused on your purpose. This helps you stay committed, because you're going to have tough days, baby. You're going to have tough days. And that's when you have to weather the storm. See, and stay focused on your principles. Stay focused on your purpose. Never forget you got babies at home. Never forget the car note's coming up, the credit card note, these things. So you don't have time to whine. We got to be big boys and big girls and just face life. Is everybody listening to me? Are you learning anything? All right. So after I've profiled and predicted and did my little pre-discovery, the guest is getting ready to come up. Before they get there, watch this, y'all. I prophesy and I be proactive. Prophesy means to say. I say something good before. I don't say things like, man, this is going to be a hard tour. I don't think I can get this one. I don't like talking like that. I say the opposite. Y'all want to hear what I say? You feel free to use it. I can book anybody from anywhere at any time on any day. That's my prophecy. That's what I speak out before I go talk to that person. I can book anybody at any time. Yeah, on any day, and they can be from anywhere. See, because a lot of times, especially if you're new, of my new people listening, hopefully you are, it can be intimidating. You know, you start shaking at the knees and get all nervous and butterflies in your stomach. And especially if the nationalities are different and you're not used to dealing with certain nationalities, all of a sudden you have to go talk to this person. It can be intimidating. See, so I tell myself, I can book anybody. I don't care who you are. I don't care where you come from. See, you're in my house. I'm the professional. My boss puts it this way. This is your commercial. See, I'm the lead actor. You came to my house. I didn't go to your house. When I go to your house, you'll tell me, sit down, take your shoes off, restroom's over there, wash your hands. You know, it's your house. See, you came to my house. Okay, I'm the lead actor here. I'm Tom Brady, baby. I'm calling the plays. Are y'all listening? So I prophesy, I can book anybody at any time from anywhere at any time. Let me interject this. I used to watch Kobe Bryant. I watched this young guy, and this is when he was just coming into championship status. Shaquille O'Neal had fouled out. It was the end of a game. I watched him look at Shaquille O'Neal, the real deal, and say, don't worry about it. I got it. I was like, whoo, I'm impressed. You heard him prophesy. He spoke. He said, don't worry. And he did. And they won the game. Tell me, y'all probably remember that game. I've seen people like Michael Jordan do that. I've seen Tom Brady do that. There's another young boy, Mahomes, over in Kansas City. I've seen him do it over and over again. Games on the line, you down, it don't look like you're going to make. I've seen listen to me. Champions have an aura about themselves. When you're facing that client, be fearless. Be the tiger. Ladies, be the tigress. Men, be the lion. Ladies, you be the lioness. Go hunt, baby. Your fam, you got cubs at home that need to eat. You got to book this tour. See? So be fearless and prophesy. I can book her. Of course I can get her. Now watch this. As long as I'm being the ultimate professional, I have to give this lady my best. See? She needs to see my smile. If you're taking notes, write this down and never forget it. I learned this years ago from a businessman. He said, smiles equal dollars. You should write that down and never forget it. See, smiles equal dollars. So when I talk to a guest, I don't look like, mm-hmm. And they don't know that I got problems at home because I don't wear it on my face. I wear a smile. Hey, welcome to such and such place. Hey, good morning. Are you Mr. So-and-so? Hey, my name's Geren, the Guaranteed Gatling. I just get into it. I'm ready to go. I want to get your attention. See? I want to let you know you come to the show, baby. This is a movie. I'm the Black James Bond. I tell people that. They say, what's your name? I say, Bond. James Bond. I get involved in it. This is my commercial. This is my movie. You in my house. And I need to get some money at your pocket, baby. I need you to swipe your credit card. So I got to put some deposits in you first. Most marketers, agents, they want to withdraw from the guest without making any deposits in the guest. Would you like me to say that again and explain it? Most marketers, I watch them. they want to make a withdrawal from the guest or the client, but they don't want to make any deposits. I don't know any bank that does that. You know, I have about, I don't know, 3 or 4 bank accounts. You know, every one of them, the reason why I can withdraw from them is because I put some money in them. That's why I can withdraw it. Anything else is called robbery, bank robbery. They lock you up for that. See, it's the same way with people. We always want to take something for, we know we need a deposit. We know we need 60 minutes, 90 minutes, 120 minutes of their time. And we want to withdraw that, but we don't want to give them anything. No, you have to make some deposits, darling. First thing you start with is your smile. Write this down, folks. Master the fundamentals. Master the fundamentals. I'm a master of the fundamentals. Okay, I've learned to master them and I constantly train on them. The first one is your introduction. Write it down, sweetheart. Come on, write. Or at least say it, introduction. Get involved in this. I'm depositing into you free information. I'm not charging anybody for any of this stuff. I want you to be successful. You know why? I was at work one day years ago when I worked for the private vending company who happened to work for a vacation club. And I remember this lady that was there and her child was there. And I was eating a hot dog. And I saw how the child was looking at me, and I'm a master at watching body language. I knew this child was hungry. And I remember in my head thinking, and this lady, and I, you know, she was half-stepping, wasn't giving her all, and your child is there hungry. You know, that bothers me when I see that kind of stuff. You're the lioness. That's your cub. You need to hunt, baby. You got to book some tours today so this child can eat. See, that's what I mean about purpose. When people know their purpose, on my leaders listening, directors, managers, supervisors, get your people to know their purpose. Once they do, they become hungry and they get committed. See, and they won't give up because it's raining or it's hot or it's cold or everything's not going hunky-dory. They're going to hunt. See? And that's what you want. You want producers, not drama queens coming to the door, always crying, complaining, this is it. We don't need that. Not if we're going to be productive. Okay? We need producers. Get hungry, baby. Get your introduction down. See, if people don't sign up with me, it's not going to be because you don't like me. It's not going to be because I don't like the way he dressed. He's got his clothes wrinkled. He smells. He ain't even cut up. You know, it's not going to be because there's dirt all through my fingernails. Never, baby. I manicure them. I'm giving you, listen, y'all, listen. I'm giving you my best self. I want you to see manicured nails, nice haircut. He got his mustache. His teeth are white. And his breath, they are actually, see, you're close to people. They smell your breath. They smell your cologne, ladies, your perfume. So don't be overpowering. Don't overdo it. But be that ultimate professional. Hey, welcome to such and such place. Good morning, Mr. Jones. My name is, you know, give them something and say something unique because they've heard it all before. You got to give them a new movie. You have to give them a new commercial, especially when you've done the pre-discovery and you're looking on your iPad or whatever device your company gives you. And you see that they just did a presentation. I had one just a couple of weeks ago, last week. They literally just left New York and did a presentation. And now they're in front of me the same day. But I have to still get you to go here. Okay, great. So I have to give them something different. That's why I love pre-discovery. I love profiling and predicting. I love looking at it and getting an idea of who I'm addressing, where they just come from. Sometimes I'm looking at them come through the lobby and they got all these suitcases and bags. I know, okay, obviously this person didn't drive here. They dropped off an Uber. Where are they from? And I go up the screen and I say, oh, California. So they had a long flight. Listen, y'all, I'm thinking. This person had a long flight. This person's in another time zone, so they're a little woozy and they're tired. See? So I automatically know I need to pick up the pace. I can't give them my long 7 minutes this time. This person, I need to get them to their suite, into a hot tub, and then into the presentation the next morning. So can you see why this stuff is so important? So give people your best self. When they walk up to you, you should be a breath of fresh air. See, they should look at you and say, this is a sharp young man. This is a sharp lady right here. This is a professional, and they're professional, and they'll respect that. It's easier to put them in the paper and book them. Are y'all listening? All right. So prophesy, say something good. I can book her. Tell yourself, I'm not intimidated. Get your inner talk right. I can book them. I'm not afraid. I can get this person. Make a prediction. Okay, I can probably get them to go on such and such a day. Okay, if I see they're real tired, one of the last things I want to do is try to get them to go right now, if there's a straight in. They're too tired. I start predicting. She's probably better off to do tomorrow. And when I'm doing my actual discovery, which I'll show you how to do in a moment, when I do that, I'm asking the right questions so I know when I can tie this person down. See? That's why all these things are so important, and you want to be a master of these fundamentals. Your introduction has to be flawless. It's like a layup. It has something you can do with your eyes closed. Okay, my introduction. How am I presenting myself to this person? Number two would be my discovery. Okay, I'm asking the proper questions. Hey, so what brings you guys into town today? See? And they'll tell you, oh, we're here for a wedding. Oh, there's a funeral. Oh, no, we're just relaxing. Oh, it's our anniversary. See, they're gonna give you that information. And you should be calculating. Okay, that means I can send them on this day at this time. I know they're going on. They want to go do some rides, so they might need a little extra cash. I may be able to give them a debit card or credit. See, I'm thinking. See, that discovery is so, so, so important. And you only need about 3 or 4 good questions. Have you guys been here before? Say, oh, welcome back. Oh, you haven't been. You came to the greatest place. It is beautiful here and whatever. And then you start getting your little pitch books or whatever materials you have. And you want to be very, very proficient with them. There goes another word with P. You want to be very, very proficient with your materials. You need to know your pitch book. You need to know your gifts. See, you need to know what times are available to put people on presentations, everything. You have to be sharp. You have to be the ultimate professional. And you practice this and you master it, because it's not going to change. The people will change a lot. You get all kinds of nationalities. You're going to get people who only do summer vacations with family. You get people on business trips. All that kind of thing may change, but not this. You still have to know your purpose. You still got to be prepared. You still have to have positivity and pop. You still got to profile and predict. You still got to prophesy. Say something good. I can book her. And then be proactive. Don't wait for the tour just to come. You know, when they start coming to you, and especially if your location allows you to sit down, when that person's coming, baby, get up. Be proactive. Go at it like a tiger. Go attack. The gazelle doesn't go to the lion and say, eat me. Did you notice that? Watch him on them little videos I talked about. No, the lion goes and be proactive. I'ma get her. See? So be proactive. When you see they need, sir, I see people, they look like they're so hot and tired. They just got in, they're standing in the line. And I know that's my person. I go get them some water. Hey, good afternoon. Welcome to such and such place. Are you guys checking in? Great. My name is Geren, and I'm going to be your guest guide today anyway. Can I get you some cold water or something? Oh, well, the restrooms are right over there. Be proactive. Get involved. You're prepping them. There goes another word with P. Prep the person. Be proactive. Attack. Predict things. You know what they're going to need. See, they might need a luggage card. You have to think. See, all the time. That's if you want to be a champion. I'm talking about a day in the life of a champion. I'm a champion, y'all. I can book tours at events, malls, in-house, outhouse, your house. It doesn't matter where I go. See, these principles work anywhere. Just master them and stay proficient at them day in, day out. And on your day off, relax. Go rest. You've earned it. Go relax yourself. Are you listening to me? And then another P is pace. I might have to make another video. Pace. Pace yourself. After you do your introduction, you're doing your discovery questions. Have you guys been here before? What do you guys have planned while you're here? See? I start saying stuff. Oh, are you in our military? Well, thank you for your service. Where do you serve? Yeah. And then learn how to relate with people. I start relating with them. I call it ERT. You may want to write that down. ERT. That's where you begin to empathize and / sympathize with people. Understand them. Hear them out when they're talking. Don't just keep throwing your pitch down their throat. Pace yourself. If I see that they're tired, pick up the pace. If I see they're happy-go-lucky and the lady just wants to talk and see, I slow down. She don't need to know what time my presentation is yet. Let her talk and then be interested. Empathize. Sympathize. Yeah, my brother just passed away. We're here for a funeral. My condolences. Oh, okay. I'm assigned to you, so if there's anything going on that I can do to help, please let me know. Here's my card with my number on it. Yeah, I had my niece had passed away, so I understand how to... See, empathize. Let them know you hear them. See? Oh, we're here for a wedding. Great! Yeah, my brother's wedding. I remember when I got married. Woo! I'm going on 9 years now. That congratulations! See, I'm empathizing, sympathizing, relating with you. See? That's where the R comes in. That's my relation. Relate with them. Give them someone of your own stories. Not a long one, because you don't want to dominate the conversation with you. You want to hear them. It's all about them. And then T stands for tie them down. You still got to tie them down. See? I found out why you're here. What days you have things planned, or if you even have anything planned. You might have to make them an itinerary. Well, guys, here goes our bus tours. You know, you want to start, you might have to help them plan something. See? And then plan in that presentation time. That's why this stuff is so important. Be the ultimate professional. Be clean, be sharp, be crisp, be prepared, be full of positivity, be full of pop. See? Do things on purpose, a master of fundamentals. Introduction. Hey guys, welcome to such and such place. My name is, are you guys first time here? See, I'm doing my little discovery questions. See, and then I'm getting ready to hit you with my pitch. All right. Now, when you hit the person with your pitch, one of the things you want to remember is to have what I like to call preemptive strikes. There goes another word with P. Preemptive strikes, because your pitch more than likely is already perfect. You more than likely got it from your company. It's been working for years, so it already works. Okay? It's those objections and obstacles. See? And people have all these other opportunities to do other things that's going to hinder your pitch. So have a preemptive strike ready. What do I mean by that? There's only like maybe 5 major objections, maybe 3. In my company, it's like the major 3. Some of them are just petty ones that you can just run over those. But those major ones, like, oh, my last presentation was horrible. They treated me like this. Those people lied to me. You know, that's one of the main ones. Another one is, I just did one. We just did that. I did 4 of these already this year. See, you're going to hear those. Those are like the main ones. Or my spouse. He don't want to go. See, or I don't have any time. I'm only here for 2 days. So you already know they're going to use those. See, especially when they're owners or they're already in a part of your company's business. The guest of and rentals and so forth, you can deal with them a little differently. But those owners know the game. See, so have a preemptive strike ready. They already like you. They would not be talking to you if they did not. If they've been there with you for 5 minutes, baby, they like you. Your breath is perfect with mint and wintergreen. Your cologne is perfect. Your perfume, your hair. Oh, she speaks so eloquent. She knows what she's doing. She helped me and gave me some water. She made proper deposits. She smiles. She gave me. I love giving people. So here's a pen. You know, have those, by the way, have collateral ready, supervisor. Give your people some collateral, stuff they can give with your company's logo. Give. So you want to help them put deposits into people, because I'm getting ready to get something from them. So let me give them something, my smile, my introduction. You know, I'm giving them my aura. You know, I have positivity and pop. I'm making them laugh. They like me. Their kids like me. I've had their kids come up and hug me. Yeah, huh, they walked through the lobby and went, hey, Geren, guarantee, everybody knows me, you know? That's what you want. See, you've created, but you created that. See, you did it. They're in your house, see? And so, be the ultimate professional and have those preemptive strikes ready. Example, if I know that a person is only here for 2 days, and then I see that it says, a lot of times we can see that how their last presentation went, and let's say it says that it was poor. They just told you, horrible. So I know. So I need to have a preemptive strike ready, because I know they want to bring those up. So what am I going to say? Hey, guys, after I did my little introduction, did my discovery, blah, 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 I'm ready to hit them with my pitch. Hey, folks, I see that you're only here for 2 days, so you don't have a lot of time. I don't wait for them to tell me they don't have no time. I'm going to tell you you don't have any. You guys only here for 2 days, so you don't have a lot of time. But I'll let them know my recommendation is you guys come and see us first thing in the morning, so you'll have the whole day ahead of you. Or my recommendation is, let's say they told me they're here for a anniversary. Tomorrow's their anniversary. I'm not booking them for that next month. No. You guys are only here for 2 days and it's your anniversary. However, as owners, you have vested interest. So we really need to get you updated on information. And there's a lot more things that our company is doing now. We've added more resorts. We've added this program. By the way, go on those websites of your company and see the new things that they're doing. So you can hit those owners with that stuff. And they don't always know. They're not even updated. They're too busy with life. They really don't even know what's going on. See? So you give them those little hints. Drop those little hooks in there. See? And so I suggest a day of checkout. First thing in the morning, stop by and see us. Get your information. And then I'm going to give you this. But be ready. Don't wait for them to tell you they don't have any time. Don't wait for them to tell you my last experience was horrible. You already saw it on the screen. You know it was horrible. Okay, so have a preemptive strike ready to hit that objection because it's coming. You don't want to be caught shocked when your client says, I had a horrible experience. I don't have time. My husband doesn't like that. You want to have something ready, a really good, flawless rebuttal that you don't have to think about or get scared about because you know it's coming. That's why you have what I call a preemptive strike. Hit it first. Learn the main objections. There's only a handful of them in this business. And then master a preemptive strike so you're ready to hit them back. Okay? There's a way to do it. And by the way, some of those people, no matter what you do, they're still not going. You still have to learn how to depart friends. Okay? Don't be mad. I've seen people that get, they say, rip things up in the client's face. Never, y'all. Never. You just ruin it for the next marketer that has to go to the next resort. Or you've ruined it for the next time they come back. And a lot of time that you're up again and it's that same person. And they're going to remember that you ripped that invite up in their face. Or that you were mean when they said no. You can't do that. Always depart friends. Okay, well, I tell you what. You guys enjoy your stay. I'll make sure I put in the notes that you said no call to the United States at the time. But maybe next time you come by, you can help us out. Okay, and here's my number. Please call me if you need anything. Help making depart friends. See, you'll make it easier for yourself the next time or for your next fellow marketer at another resort. Got it? Okay. And then I'm going to come back next time and actually give you a pitch. You know, I'm just giving you my stuff. But I'm going to show you how to do that. I might even practice some rebuttals, you know, for these objections, preemptive strikes. But the main thing today I want you to get in the day of the life of a champion is the number one, guys, have some purpose. Ladies, have purpose. Know why you're here. What am I doing on the earth? I didn't just plop here. You know, there's a reason why I'm here. Okay? Why am I here? What's my goal in life? What do I want to accomplish? What do I want to be? I don't want to be an in-house marketer all my life. See, this is just a stepping stone to take me where I want to go. I have big dreams, y'all. Big dreams. Okay? But I understand that there's a preparation time. See? And I tell you what, if you want to be somebody that's actually running a team one day or have your own company one day, you have to be the employee that you want to be at your job. You want to be that person that this is the kind of person I would hire. Would you hire you if you were always late, always grumpy, always having personal problems, can't book a tour, negative all the time? Would you hire that person? See, so you want to be the professional. See, professional people know their purpose. They know what they want. They have a plan. They have budgets. They know where the money's going. This is life, baby. Okay, this is very, very real. And then prepare yourself. Take care of yourself from the inside out. Take time to read. If you have any type of religious background, take time to practice that. It will help you. It helps you with equilibrium, with a peace of mind. You have to do that kind of stuff, folks. Also, make sure you take care of your body. That has a lot to do with how you're performing at work. There goes another word with P, performance. Has a lot to do. If you're always sluggish and tired, there's something wrong with your body. We need to do something about that. Address it. Find out some stuff. Get involved with those things and programs that your company has. And make sure you get the proper fuel and the proper rest. These things will help you be a optimum producer as an in-house marketer or a CMP or whatever your company calls them. Okay? Make sure you're taking care of self. When you take care of yourself, you feel good. When you feel good, you perform well. All the time, consistently. I like to call it optimum results. I have to operate at a high level all the time. See? So even if it does look like it's a bad day, I still can produce at a high level. 57, 60, 70% maybe. I'd rather have 80, 90, 100, just get everybody. But the reality is you're not going to, but you still have to think high. See, produce. Also, make sure you park your personal problems. When you go to your job, please don't dump your stuff on other people. That's very immature, number one. It's very selfish. It's not right. See, that lady's already dealing with stuff. She's got her own child. So you don't know what people are going through. So don't dump your stuff on people. It's not right. Park your car, park the problem. We'll deal with it later. There's programs and things available to deal with that stuff. By the way, there goes another word with P, programs. Okay? Make sure when you come through the door, you have positivity. Pop. Come in with energy. See? You're the lead actor. Nobody can do you better than you. You're the only Melissa or Geren or whomever. That's you. So when you walk in, be that person. Make sure you're professional, clean. Even if it's khakis, man, they're pressed. You know, everything's clean and sharp. And people can see it. They see, look at her nails, nice and clean. She's not overdoing it. Nice, pretty. People love that. Professional people love to see that. Okay? Also, don't forget to profile and predict. When you're ready to book somebody, take time to look things over. Do a pre-discovery. Look up the notes. Find out about that person. What was their last gift? How was their last presentation? Are they VIPs? Are they priorities? You see, we didn't know this stuff. And when they come up, we introduce ourselves with positivity and pop. We do a quick discovery, and then we watch our pace. If the person is rushing, we pick it up. If the person is going slow, then we slow it down. See, we have to be in full control of yourself. And you master fundamentals. Be a master of your gifts. Know your pitch book. Know where you are with your numbers. How many tours I need to book today. What do I need to do to hit that next level? You need to know. How far away am I from being in this elite club? What can I do to improve that? Ask questions. Put pressure on your leaders. Put pressure on them. Ask them, where are my notes? Where's my numbers? Where's this? Where's that? Put pressure on it. Everybody put pressure on one another. And you can be a champion. The truth of the matter is, honey, you already are. We just have to bring your potential to the table in full bloom. My name is Geren Gatling. I'm positive you learned something today. If you'll listen to this at least once a week or listen to it 5 times a week for the next 30 days. And when you get to work, I guarantee you, your boss will notice a difference in you. Your numbers will prove it. Your money will improve. Everything will improve. And you will be the ultimate professional in your industry. Thank you for watching.